smoking foil is pot. Heard I'm sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock.
Just like the hands on the clock, I go back to back when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm driving the bus, so they threw me under. Heard they mad they don't want to bust, so they boo each other. Think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you.
I hate to break about me and myself, top two. I blow away the competition like a bowl of hot soup.
And there's no catch, I go and get the bag and I'm not bringing it back. I'm like a down QB, I put the pain in the past. And if you ever had a problem, promise I didn't ask. So it's 444 in the car, my dash. I shake a pic, told them all, you ain't first, you last. Little boy, that's facts, I'ma grow that cash to my money.
You know what, let me stop.
Yeah, I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. I turn the knob, can't resist, I'm incredible. Yeah, came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Then I did the dash, can I catch me, bro? Ooh, then I did the dash, can I catch me, whoa? Your whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. Running up the charts, I'm a fool, dog.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to our nation's capital at FedEx Field in Landover, Maryland. They love their football in this part of the country, and this crowd is ready to go as their guys will match up with the Seattle Seahawks. Dustin Hopkins has it on the tee, and here we go from our nation's capital. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
Take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Hey, why, man?
Have we got Mike, number 50?
Alert!
On first and 10, it's Wilson. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Troy Aikman. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. That right there is the inauspicious start that they were hoping to avoid, the turnover on the first possession.
I love how you use those college-bound words like that, inauspicious. Well done. I really appreciate that. But here's the thing for me. I'm just wondering if their game plan is incorrect. You know, I think they felt like they could come in and throw it around pretty well. That interception early, they may rethink how they go about attacking.
A tackle made by K.J. Wright. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
Babies cry all the way back home, y'all. Let's make these babies
hurt.
Way back home.
Kill. Turn up. Kill. Turn up. Check 24. Check up.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism. They created some nice space for him.
Check. He don't want it.
Throwing on third down, Smith.
You can't block me. You can't.
And he's going to have the connection to Foster. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
What we hear so often, how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game, but it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go up and make the tackle right away.
Rush in!
They'll run. It's Miller.
Undercross.
Lamar Miller. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. Wow, first and goal, and defensively, all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down.
Well, I know defensive coordinator is going to be pretty excited about what he just saw there. Great knockback by their front. And now with the ball where it is, I would expect to see the offense throw the ball on second and third down here.
Ready,
Second and goal from the six this time.
Watch 54. Watch 54. I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you.
Now a play fake. And it's Smith. Eluding the pressure right. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete. Thomas, the intended target, but now it's third and goal.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Hey, we gotta get this stop here, D.
Mike's
tracking 60.
Mike's 5-4.
Now Smith on third and goal. Just what Seattle was hoping for. The coverage holds, and now fourth down. The safety, Jamal Adams, able to break that one up.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. I have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return.
First and 10 at their own 31-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They threw an interception the first time they had the football. Only gave up 3 points off of that, so it shouldn't be a difficult hold to overcome.
It really shouldn't, as long as they're not listening to the chatter coming from the other side, because when you throw a pick, look, I know defensive backs, they have a tendency to be a little bit loud after they take one away. But they also have a tendency to gamble a little bit more, thinking they'll get a second one. Maybe they can take advantage of that with some double moves.
Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Here's Carson with a catch out of the backfield. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
Well, that was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down. And that's exactly what he did.
Wilson's throw caught by Metcalf. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. 7 yards the pick up there. Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Again, Wilson. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. The DN, Jonathan Allen, making sure his presence is felt. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA power forward. It's really a difficult task.
And he's unable to haul it in, so it falls incomplete over the middle third of the field, and that brings up fourth. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
53's Mike. You're going night-night. You're going night-night.
36 power.
53, Mike.
Here we go on fourth with Wilson. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep left side. And that will fall incomplete. Oh, they took a shot there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Check nine, check nine.
Watch safety creep. Watch safety creeping. Safety's creeping.
They'll start out here with a jet sweep. And defensive back Jamal Adams in on the stop. Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
Eight yards to go on second down. Now Smith. And he'll complete this to Gibson. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line.
That's good.
He got 29 yards that time.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
They'll try and run for Miller. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3.
And Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line. Because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
Alert flare, 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 alert 3, alert 3.
On second down, it's Gibson. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2.
At the 2 yard line, a gain of 3 yards. It's now third down.
Gibson. Defense didn't budge on third down. Now what are we going to see on fourth?
We are soon to find out, but does this feel like old school football or what?
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
This is an old-fashioned goal line stand. I know what I would call on offense. I would go for it. I want some type of a play where my quarterback has a chance to run it or throw it. I don't just want one static play.
So scores on their first two possessions, but 6-0, so field goals probably not what they were hoping for.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that. Not what they were hoping for, but they should be happy that they have points on the board. It almost feels like that old slow and steady wins the race, doesn't it? In this case, though, they want to be slow and steady now, but get explosive later and put the points up on the board.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. Good job by their defense, though. They held them to 3, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than 3. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. There's Wilson. They'll run the screen with Carson. And he is not going anywhere. He will not even get back to the line of scrimmage as the clock will stop at the 2-minute warning. Now the offense failed earlier on the previous crack at this, but they're going again on fourth down.
Check curls, check curls, check 14, 14, find it.
They'll indeed go for it with Wilson. He lets it fly for Lockett, and he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Troy Apke. And he will bring this one back. It is a pick six for a Washington touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Hopkins with the extra point, and the lead now stands at 13.
Justin Hopkins to kick off.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They find themselves down 13-0 here as they try to get things started offensively. First and 10. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked by Kendall Fuller. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing the second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake. Gibson gets hit and he fumbles it. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And he is not quite going to make it all the way in. They'll mark him down right about the 1-yard line. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players?
And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Russell Wilson on target to DK Metcalf. And the Seahawks have made this a one-score game. Had the option there, read it perfectly, and an easy little touchdown.
And it has to be a sharp throw, too, because of where they are on the field, the extra traffic, things are condensed near the goal line. Good route by the receiver as well.
Myers connects on the PAT, and it's now 13-7.
Myers to kick off for Seattle.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive.
Brings up second and three at the 30-yard line.
SOS.
On second down now, it's Gibson. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. Setting up the screen for Miller. The ball comes out, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. Well, CD, that's the second time this half they've put it on the carpet. Now, the first one they lost. Good news here, it doesn't cost them.
They do say that things even out in the course of a ball game. So you mentioned they lost the first one. This time, able to retain possession, but they can't get into this half.
The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off at the 40. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line. How about the big boys snagging one? You don't see that every week.
No, you don't, but a lot of them are just reliving their old dreams, going back to when they were in youth football and in high school. They didn't always play defensive line. Some of them actually handled the football, and you can see the flashback when he grabbed that one.
Left side complete to Lockett. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. It's a gain of 15. First down, Seahawks. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did.
Well, sometimes those cliches really come true, don't they? When they talk about it takes all 11 to play good defense. We've seen that in this ball game. I think the secondary has to be singled out, though. They are in the presence of every receiver whenever the ball's thrown. And this one, they help force another incompletion.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Throwing again, Wilson. And his throw here is incomplete. Chris Carson, the intended receiver. But now it's third down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap. He locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Escaping the pressure right. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half.
For the Seahawks field goal. A 53-yard attempt.
And this one is no good. He missed it. And this score will stay right where it is. And that's the risk of the long field goal miss here at this stage of the second quarter. You give up great field position.
And that gives them one more opportunity to make something happen and something big. And we've seen crazy stuff happen at the end of halves.
54 is Mike. Ring alert. Ring alert. Watch 54. Watch 54.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. This is caught by his tight end, Logan Thomas. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call.
That's the reason we ball for circle round twice.
And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half.
Here we go. Watch the pass. Watch the pass.
The final shot here before break. Smith slings this deep for McLaurin. And this one is incomplete. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three.
Jason Myers to kick off for Seattle.
So Washington in a good spot. They've got the lead. They will get the football as the second half gets underway. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness.
Making it happen, Captain.
And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Jason Myers for the extra point.
Short throw, pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Sack, Viking 18.
All day, every day, any day. Safe. Check it out.
They'll try and get the run game going. This is Miller. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
He'll have a first down across the 40, and he's got it across the 50 to the 47-yard line. 27 yards there, a first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he's struggling, especially that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Now again, right side. Gibson. And he loses the football a second time.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. Off of play action, here's Smith. That's complete to his receiver, McLaurin. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 33. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down.
We got to get the ball, D. Get the ball right here. Let's go. Shift, shift. Watch the safety creep. Kill.
And again, this time the tailback. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10.
They'll keep it on the ground. It's Gibson. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down.
Mark 50.
Smith. And get this to Antonio Gibson complete. And this play going to be stopped in its tracks at the 32, and obviously well short of the first down. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of two there. So now the field goal unit trots out there for the third time tonight. It'll be a 49-yard attempt from the left hash. And Hopkins hangs this one out to the right. Missed it. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. Down here in the third quarter, obviously that's one they could have used.
Yeah, and one of my favorite special teams coaches in the NFL told me what separates the kickers in the NFL versus the ones who are not, it's not the misses. It's the second miss in a row. Best kickers in the league, they don't miss two in a row. He's got to get his head back together in case he gets another shot.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, come get a little bit closer to this guy. Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Back now at FedEx Field. The Seahawks on third down. 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. Here it's 3rd and 3. And he finds a man. It's Olsen. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. That'll pick up the first down for Seattle on a gain of 18.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Get in the weight room.
And the Seahawks.
Get in the weight room.
First down.
Switch. Switch.
Tuck.
Throwing is Wilson. And it's a quick slant to Lockett. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Another nice gain. 13 yards that time and another first down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12.
The tackle made.
Jimmy Moreland there on the stop. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in. And all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score. And this game's over.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Here's Wilson to throw. And he's going to go down. Sacked right around the 17. Jonathan Allen able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
Fourth quarter, 2 minutes on the clock in a tight one-point game. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Myers' kick is good. And that'll move their lead up to 4 now. So they get the 3, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now because they'd feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction. All of a sudden, they're down. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. Well, let's face it, we've been there. We've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
Looking again for Thomas, this time complete. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. Now Smith. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue. He's got the first down and more past midfield. And gets it across the 50 and down to the 48. It'll go as a pickup of 14 and a Washington first down. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Mike's 50, Mike's 50.
Play action. It's Smith. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third. On third down, Gibson. Yeah, boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. It's good for a gain of seven, but still a few inches short here with fourth down coming up. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow, wow. How many people watching this one right here who gave up? Because that score, they might want to try and rush back into this stadium.
Yeah, what looks like is going to be the game-deciding score, although a little bit of time left, so you can't count your chickens before they're hatched.
Well, they better come back in here and watch this one because you and I, we're not going anywhere. We want to see this one play out.
Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. Wilson to throw. He finds his man, the tight end Olsen. Now the Seahawks call the second of their three timeouts as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Watch the screen. 56, the mark.
Throwing now is Wilson. Flushed out right. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Now the Seahawks forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in the football game. So on fourth down, here's Jason Myers for the Seahawks field goal. And Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Now here's Jason Myers. He gets set for the Seahawks field goal. This to potentially send us to overtime. And his kick is no good. Oh, by the slimmest of margins, he...